Imagine your favorite places on Earth. Chances are, you're thinking of skiing down Mount Hood or hiking around Crater Lake. Yet, we spend 90% of our lives indoors. So the question is, how can we design and use our buildings and homes to be more like our favorite places, and even help to support our health? My name is Kevin Van Den Wymelenberg. I am the director at the Institute for Health in the Built Environment and a professor of architecture at the University of Oregon. For nearly 200 years, we've been waging war on microbes. We buy mountains of household cleaning products, which has dramatically increased our exposure to indoor antimicrobial compounds. Now, some microbes are good for us, commonly called probiotics, while others are really destructive to human health. These are called germs or pathogens. If we primarily focus on murdering microbes with our scorched earth cleaning practices, we not only miss an opportunity to forge healthier spaces, but we also create unintended consequences. We've discovered that more antimicrobial compounds is associated with increased abundance of antibiotic-resistant bacteria indoors. A lot of other people are studying your gut microbiome, which can improve digestion, mood, and mental health, or your skin microbiome, which can have immunoprotective effects. But we're studying your building microbiome. How might the microbiomes we unintentionally design into our indoor spaces impact our well-being? And can we use design to shape them more intentionally? We consume architecture with our eyes, but we actually consume indoor spaces with our entire person. We breathe in our buildings. In fact, we breathe in about 3 billion bacterial cells every day. The architectural decisions that we're making about placement and size of windows or access to fresh air all impact our health in different ways, maybe from how the access to daylight and views affects alertness to low-dose chronic exposure that might cause asthma through, excessive exposure to chemicals indoors. In more extreme cases, the buildings we interact in can mediate the spread of viruses like the novel coronavirus or other pathogens like C. diff, which has been known to cause more than 100,000 deaths every year. If we want to promote human health, then building design matters. Great architecture creates the spatial presence to inspire the soul. It provides shelter, comfort, safety, and supports productivity, and can support health in unprecedented ways. Through design, we shape these microbial and chemical landscapes, and in turn, they shape us.